Welcome back to The Ad Show, where we're talking road safety campaigns with our experts, Niki Harre of the University of Auckland and motoring journalist John Oxley. They're just two of a number of experts who believe that trying to shock us into being better drivers just isn't working. But what would? Here's a new UK campaign that's taken another tack. And more emotion there. I saw quite a few people in the audience actually smiling. John, what do you think of that ad?
I thought it was great. You know, it's a warm feeling ad, and if you want to win people over, it's a lot better to give them a warm feeling than to scare the living daylights out of them. People respond better to love than they'll ever respond to fear.
Okay, and Niki, we're talking about positive reinforcement. What should we be doing?
I mean, I think the ad was pleasant to watch. The kind of ads that I really think work are ads that show clearly what to do. So we've had a whole series of ads, you know, if you drive your mates when they've been drinking, so that shows clearly what you do. Other ads where somebody stays the night, takes out his guitar rather than drives home. So I guess I would favour ads that show really specifically and clearly what you do. That ad was more about the emotion and staying with the family rather than, I guess what I'd favour is an ad showing somebody putting on their seatbelt with their children and really performing and modelling that behaviour.
Thank you very much, Niki, and to you too, John. Now for something completely different and much less grisly. This month, Facebook overtook Google as the most popular website in the US. Its popularity is giving rise to new marketing techniques, such as Facebook applications. Here's an example, the wildly popular Whopper Sacrifice.
A Whopper or your friends? Burger King created a Facebook application to find out which was more valuable. Each time a Facebooker deleted 10 friends, they got a free Whopper, and BK got free advertising. With only a few press releases and online ads, this viral spread like wildfire. In under 10 days, nearly 234,000 Facebookers were defriended for the sake of more than 23,000 burgers.
Okay, it looks like fun, but is it just a gimmick? With me is Adam Good, CEO of AIM Proximity, to explain a little bit more. Adam, what's a Facebook application and why should we care?
It's actually a framework for software developers to actually develop applications and ideas inside the Facebook platform.
So tell me about some of the applications you've seen that have been quite successful, like Air New Zealand is one that comes
yeah,
to mind.
Look, certainly the spooning app that's out in the last couple of weeks is an interesting phenomena.
Can you explain a little bit about what's involved?
Look, Air New Zealand have these innovations that they've launched in regards to their premium economy and business class. And one of the innovations is called the Sky Couch.
Yep.
And what that actually is a product that allows economy class to actually have flat bed or have a bed.
Yep.
And what that has driven, actually, when you see this sort of configuration, is people are sort of saying, look, I mean, you're lying down next to your partner, you know, what's going to happen on the airline? And some conversations have been started, and Air New Zealand are very, very good at looking at ways that those conversations started and trying looking at ways that they can inflame them, I suppose, and keep them moving along. So why not develop a spooning app and give people the idea of you know, what the history of spooning is all about? And Facebook's a really great platform for that. So you actually go to Facebook, you install this application, and you can spoon your friends.
OK, let's talk about some of the limitations of what you can and can't advertise on Facebook. Firearms, for one.
Certainly can't do firearms. Yeah.
Anything else?
Oh, look, I mean, I think they change their rules all the time. People are trying to work out ways that they get on that wall. I mean, when you log on to Facebook, there's about 1.4 million New Zealanders now in Facebook, which 50% of them are active every day. And it's something like between 15 and 39-year-olds, there's actually 70% of the population are in Facebook. But they log on and they see that wall and they see their activity of their friends. So, I mean, that's where people are. They're hanging out in that space. 8-minute sessions, 50 minutes a day. So this is a real game changer in marketing. You know, how do we actually get part of that conversation?
Okay, so with Facebook overtaking Google, is this a sign that the web's becoming more sociable than searchable?
Well, I think so. I think people are realising that there's certain platforms that people just want to start their day in. And if you can actually drag content into an environment that you're actually feeling pretty engaged in, you know, that's affecting Google at this stage. I mean, Google's is the gorilla in the room, I suppose. But Facebook's driven by sort of 300% growth in the US, and New Zealand's is on the same sort of growth pattern at the moment. I mean, you know, getting on that wall, you know, how do we get those messages in our Facebook wall each day? And, you know, we're trying really hard to do that. I think the World Cup rugby is actually a really interesting case study at the moment. There's 300,000 people engaged in World Cup rugby. It's a long way away. But, you know, looking at ways that content can actually be created on whether it's merchandising or whether it's videos, and, of course, ticket sales will come next.
OK, I have to check that one out. Thank you very much, Adam.
No problem.
After the break, we meet the man who helps head a $7 billion agency network, and we get his take on what makes an award-winning ad.